We're given a process that takes place at constant pressure, and we add heat to the system and the volume increases. We're asked to calculate delta E, which is the change in internal energy, and for a number of textbooks, this would be called delta U, and then delta H was the change in enthalpy. We're going to use essentially two things here. Delta H is just a definition, delta E plus delta PV. And so this is delta E for the system. We're looking at the pressure is constant, so it's P delta V. And then delta E, we can use the first law of thermodynamics, it's Q plus W. We're given Q, we need to calculate W, and W is minus the pressure times the volume change because the process is at constant pressure. And so we can calculate by substituting in, so minus 12 bar multiplied by the volume change in liters. This would give us the work in liter bars, and so now we need a conversion factor. And that conversion factor is 1/10 of a kilojoule is equal to 1 bar liter. So I've looked that conversion factor up. That means I can now cancel, and now I have work in kilojoules. And this is minus 14.9 kilojoules. So I can calculate delta E, the change in internal energy, Q, that's given, 125 kilojoules, W, minus 14.9 kilojoules. And so delta E, 110.1, I'm going to, because of significant figures, call that 110 kilojoules. Let's go back and calculate delta H. Well, delta H, delta E, let's write delta E in terms of Q plus W. Q plus W is Q minus P delta V, and then we have this second term. So we see that for this constant pressure process, delta H is just equal to Q, and that's 125 kilojoules.